real quick. I just have a bet that I'd like to issue to some believer, some Christian believer out there. In the middle of the week sometime, I heard somebody, you know, one of these ranting guys talking about how the rapture is going to happen during their lifetime, and it's going to happen during their lifetime.
Rolling my eyes. Can, you know,
yeah, you know, you hear this a lot, right? So I'm issuing a bet to anybody that believes this, that believes the rapture is going to happen during their lifetime. This person and I make a bet. If it happens recognizably by society that, yes, the rapture is happening, and we can agree, I will hit my knees and convert and beg Jesus' mercy on the spot. If it doesn't and this person dies, they owe me $100,000. And,
right.
and I'm making
put your
I'm,
money
I'm
where your mouth
this
is,
out there
right?
As a bet right now.
I like that idea.
Yeah. Get them all to put it, you know, in escrow right now.
That's what I'm thinking, you know. Mm-hmm. And we'll have it signed, like the whole big thing, documentation. So if anybody calls in, responds to this, hey, I'm listening.
Make a website.
Of course, if any of them are ever actually, like, shot, you're the prime suspect.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It does have some loose ends. I'll give you that.
Well, there's various groups that have claimed that the world's going to end such and such date. And
Jehovah's Witnesses
is one. Yeah, and, you know. Every single date that's coming past, it hasn't happened. You're wrong.
I figure this is an easy $100,000 for me. So.
Yep, yeah. Absolutely. That's a good bet.
Okay, thanks
for thanks for calling. Let's take some more callers.
We got, is it Camille?
Yeah.
Hello?
Not Camille. Who's this?
This is Eric.
Hey, Eric, how you doing?
Okay. All right. And it's a little off topic, too. I've just picked this little tidbit up in a magazine. I didn't know if y'all wanted to respond to this, and it's real brief. But seven state constitutions are statements of citizens' rights, limit or deny the right of atheists and agnostics to hold public office.
Right.
Yep.
In Texas, Maryland, North Carolina, South Carolina, Maryland, Tennessee, and Pennsylvania.
They're never enforced, and if anybody ever tried to enforce them, they'd be overturned right off the bat. This is something that I'd like to see atheist groups actively involved in, and that is get this nonsensical, archaic crap out of the constitutions. It's not supposed to be there anyway, but if we can get it removed, then 10 years down the road, we won't have to have this big public fight because some asshat decides to say that, look, it says here in the Constitution that you can't do thus and so. Mm-hmm. You know, I'd really like to see people take action on
that. It's like a weight around your neck.
You know, first I'd like to see some dictionaries get their definition of atheism changed and stop including the archaic synonym for atheism of immoral. You know, that's just absurd.
Yeah. Right. Thanks. That's really all I had today.
Okay.
All right. Thanks. Appreciate the call. Well, we're down to a few minutes left. We got. Is it Wanda?
Yeah.
Hey, Wanda. How you doing?
Well, I just want to say one thing. I don't have but a minute.
That's about much time we got.
If my mother had aborted me before I was born, she'd be doing me a favor.
You really feel that way?
Yeah.
Some people do feel that way.
Yeah, I wouldn't be facing death now.
Yeah, but you also wouldn't have had all the life that led up to that death. So I guess it's a...
I only had one kid. Mm-hmm. You know, I left my husband so he could remarry and have more kids, but he married three more times and never did have any more kids. So we didn't have our quota.
Okay.
I better hang up.
All right, thanks, Wanda.